What's up, Zombie Slayers? This is KJ48, and welcome back to my 7 Days to Die single-player Let's Play. Last video, we started working on the rooftop patio. If you haven't checked it out, you should definitely go check it out. This video, we will be continuing work on the rooftop patio and probably finishing it. I'm thinking 90% we're going to finish it today. If you end up enjoying this video, please remember to give that like button a little of the old clickety-click. Also, if you're new here, please subscribe for more daily videos. All right, so I actually, on stream last weekend, did a bunch of grinding. Let me show you what I got so far. Alright, so we're going ahead and putting a bunch of stone into this forge, making cement. We got a bunch of iron in this forge. We are making steel. Look at all that iron. We got iron in this forge as well. Check out the steel and the iron being made. And this one as well. And look at all the iron. Look at all the steel. We actually got some forged iron too. It's looking pretty sweet. Basically, for the stream, I just spent the whole stream hitting boulders. This is all the stone that I got from it. I did a lot of work, man. I spent most of the stream beating on boulders, and I spent the second part of the stream designing the rooftop patio. So let's go up there and see what I've decided on. First of all, I just want to say thank you in the comments. Three times thank you for all you guys who gave me this idea. Check it out. Use these. What are they called? What is the actual name for them? They are called wood catwalk. Okay. So yeah, you guys told me to use these wood catwalks up here and put the railings on the side of them, and it's going to make it so I can use this corner wood catwalk here. So you can see this was my idea, and this doesn't look bad. I mean, it's okay. You know, it's pretty cool, but this looks cooler. This definitely looks cooler. So the only thing I like more about the corners is I can do this, and because of that, I could put lights on the corners. But I still think this looks a lot more slick, so I'm gonna definitely go with this build. And yeah, you do have a little bit of a walk-up area here, but considering it's like an overlook railing part, I really don't mind too much. I think it actually works pretty well. All right, so the other thing I did is I went ahead and designed the inside of... Basically, I decided I'm gonna have to go with big, fat, thick glass, and these are going to be the walls, and then inside is going to be, well, why don't I just do it right now, because there's no reason not to. Inside we are going to have three beer coolers against this wall, like so. Plenty of beer for everyone. And over here we're going to have a little bar with some stools. You know, not too bad. Not a ton of room up here, but I did what I could with it, and I think it came out pretty good. Now, one thing that was brought to my attention is I didn't think I could get bar stools in the game. You can't craft bar stools, right? Can't craft them. See? Well, you just got, yeah, see? Stools. Can't craft bar stools. We got storage chests, shelves, a bunch of blocks, but you can't craft bar stools. If you can craft bar stools in any way, please let me know, and I will destroy these, because I brought these in via the creative menu. Now, someone brought to my attention, I think you might be able to get these off traders, but I want these bar stools now. Traders suck, okay, in my personal opinion. Just my own opinion with the game. I did not spend a ton of time with them, but every time I go to traders, they never have what I need, and I need to make this bar. So I'll tell you what, I will throw out some materials right now to make up for these bar stools, okay? I will pretend that I crafted them. Now, what would bar stools take? Probably forged iron. Three bar stools are not going to take more than 60 forged iron. Boom, forged iron is gone. Bar stools would probably also take some wood. There's 400 wood, okay? I just throw out way more materials than would ever, ever cost for a bar stool. And then what I'll do is if I do find these at the trader, because I do go to the trader from time to time, if I find these at the trader, then I will buy them from the trader and then pick these up, destroy them, and replace down the one from the trader. But I don't think I'm going to find these at the trader. And I need these bar stools now. I'm trying to make a freaking bar up here. You know, what if I have some ladies over, and they come up here, and there's no freaking place to sit down with their beers? They're going to leave. They're going to go next door, you know, to the party pad over there. You know, they have big parties over there at the Ostrich Hotel sometimes, and that's a ladies' hangout, and I need to compete. So I need the bar stool, guys. Let's continue building here. So let's go ahead. And I want to see how I'm going to do this. So I am using business glass blocks. And I do want the opening to be there. I don't think I even need wood there, to be honest. I think we're just going to have this all glass. I think what we'll do is we'll leave a couple spots open for... Now, this needs to be more open, I think. So you know what we're going to do? We're going to break that out in the middle. And we're going to leave some windows open here as well. So let's... This is going to be that. So let's put one here. A couple windows here. One window here. Yeah, one window should be good. Well, you want windows because this place is supposed to be open for airflow. I mean, it's supposed to be like an outdoor type thing. As a matter of fact, I might even have too many. Oops, didn't mean to do that. Maybe I should put more walkways in. Yeah, you know what? I think we're going to have three walkways in. This is one of those outdoor bar things that should not have a lot of walls up. I mean, I do have some walls, but I'm going to leave as many openings as I can. I think that's pretty cool. I think that's pretty nice. So let's go ahead and we got to replace this. Let's see if we can get this down quick. Oh, no, that doesn't work. Okay, so we messed that up. That's fine. I'm okay with that. All right, so that goes there. You go there, 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 and there. Okay. All right, so that's a nice amount of openings right there. I kind of like it. This one's going to fall. Nothing we can do about it. And this one's going to fall as well. Ugh. Oh, maybe not. It's being held up by something. Being held up by the glass next to it, of course. All right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to grab these Adobe Peach ramps. And I think we're also going to need our pickaxe. And right here. Should I upgrade that? Nah. We'll leave it for now. All right. And then we're going to put this one right here. Right here. Okay. There we go. And we got that one right there. So now we're starting to look good here. How high do I want this to be? Make it pretty high, I guess. At least two more. There we go. There we go. And is this going to work for me? Yes, it is. Okay. Is that pretty good? I think that's pretty good. Do we want to seal it up with glass on top? Or, I'll probably put that right in the middle. That might not look too bad. Like a little airflow up there? Maybe. Yeah, I'm going to go grab the Adobe pole. I think I have an idea for the top that might look pretty cool, like more ventilation, more open area. It might look pretty cool. If not, I'll just tear it down. Let's take a look. Let's see what we can do here. So we're going to take this Adobe Peach pole. And what we're going to do is we're going to put this along the top. And then, like, on top of the glass. And then it's going to be kind of open. Like, more... it's all about ventilation with this. I just want this to be as open as possible with still having cool windows and stuff like that. So I'm thinking put these, like... right in the middle. You going to go in the middle or what? These do go in the middle, don't they? Did I miss it or... hold on. Let's try one more time. I want it in the middle going this way. Can we get that? Maybe I have to do it like from this side. Huh, that's so weird. It's not going in the middle. It can go in the middle this way, but not the other way. That is interesting. Huh. Okay. I mean, I could just put blocks across the top. But that just seems kind of, I don't know, boring, doesn't it? Like, I could just put these just right across the top, right? I mean, it's kind of boring. You know what? Let's get some iron bars. We haven't used iron bars a lot in this build. I think our iron bars might be pretty cool. It'll give a lot of ventilation up there. Like I said, this is supposed to... the idea of this room is for it to be an open room. It's supposed to be quite open. Not totally open, but it's going to be quite open. That's for sure. So let's come on down here. Let's come over here. Let's make some more iron bars. We need more iron bars anyway. This one doesn't have clay. This one has plenty. So let's see what you got for iron bars. There you go. 15. That's fine. And yeah, that's okay. All right. We're going to let that steel be made. It's all right. We don't need these iron bars right away. Oh, also when I was hitting those boulders, I got quite a bit of stuff to make gunpowder with. So they're making a lot of gunpowder. That's good. That's going to be enough for the next horde. So that is pretty cool. All right, so let's get up here and let's put this in our hot bar. And I'm trying to decide how I want to do this. And that should be pretty good. So I think what we'll do is we'll put the glass in. We're going to need more of this glass. Like so. And then put the iron bars across the top. The iron bars give it a little bit too much of a prison type feel. But I don't know. I still kind of... I think it's okay. I think the iron bars are okay. The only thing I don't know is how I'm going to do the ceiling. Let's put this stuff down. Let's put the rest of this glass down and we'll try and decide how we're going to do the ceiling here. All right, so this is going to come up. There we go. This is going to be another door. Yeah, that's fine. All right, so you're going to come across the top. You will be open for nice big windows. Big old windows. I like big windows. Okay. Over here, that's going to be another window. You can come right across the top. And we are out of glass. Okay, so this looks really nice. This looks really cool. And then what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to take some of these TVs. And there and there. A couple TVs. Sports bar, you know. Might want to watch the, I don't know what kind of game would be on it during the apocalypse. But you never know. You never know. That's one thing I always say. Alright, so now we got to figure out how we're going to do the roof. The roof is going to be interesting. Alright, here we are, just trying to figure out some of the roof stuff. What are these things called? Shingles, right? Yeah, shingles. We need some corner shingles. That's interesting. Alright, yeah, we're going to need some corner pieces. I don't know how many. Probably four, but I'll make a few more just in case I mess something up. Alright, so we got this started, so let's go ahead. Are we going to have this go up like that? I think we are. Let's go ahead and grab this part. And let's put these like so. Okay. Now how are these going to go on the side? We've got some corner pieces yet. There they are. Alright, let's get on over here. This should be a better place to build from. There we go. Alright, that's looking good. Okay. So how do we want this to work? So this is if this is going to be like that, it's going to go like there. And then this is going to come out like this. And this is going to go up like this. And then we need some corner pieces. So I think a corner piece right there will work. And then we're going to need another full block down here. Another one like that. Like that. And another corner piece. And I think that's going to be the roof. It's pretty cool because the roof will obviously be over the bar, but it'll also be over the areas around the bar. So theoretically, if it's like raining and stuff, you could still like walk outside, you know, and kind of be over here. Like, let's see, there's a roof right there, right? Okay. So let's say, you know, you're drinking in the bar and it's like, it's getting a little rowdy in here. People are getting a little crazy. You know, maybe you want a little bit of, you know, maybe you want to take a girl out in the balcony and get to know her and something. Come out here and the roof will still be somewhat over you here. So if it's raining, you can kind of just chill here. And I would actually consider even bringing the roof out farther, but I think it'll be okay like that. I think I can live with that. Yeah, that should work. And then the inside. Yeah, okay. So so bring this out like that. We're going to have to put some items inside here to support until we get the pole, until we get the rest of the iron bars. Yeah, I kind of like the iron bars. I mean, I don't know. I could replace the iron bars with the glass, but like I said, I want the air to flow through here. I want this to be a very airy, flowing room. I'm not even going to put any doors on this room. So, yeah. All right, let's get up here. Let's get back up on that roof. Okay. There we go. Let's get up here. All right. Very good, very good. So that's on top of that, right? Yeah, so this can go like this. And like so. And okay, so we're going to need extra support here until we get the iron bars ready. Just put one little block there. Should be plenty. And there we go. All right. So we're going to have to build some stuff over here for us to walk on. Alright, so this would be coming out like this. Come on. Work with me. There you go. And this would come out like this. Okay. Alright, yeah, so, okay, so these will be, like, right here. Come on, give me what I need. Now, is that right? I believe it is. I think this is right. I'll check it off camera, but I'm, like, after the video, but I'm pretty sure what I'm doing here is right. Basically, what I'm going to do is, after the video, I'm going to go into DM mode and fly out there and grab a nice, sexy screenshot. You guys will have already seen it, but, yeah. All right, so that could be flat. Yeah, that's fine. Well, maybe one more. I want this to be, like this on the inside. Like that. Yeah, that works. And then a flat one. Yes. Yes. Yes, sir. That is good. Okay. Let's get back up there. Oh. Love it. Let's get back up here. Yeah, we can just place all these up here. All right. Just like this. All right, and then this will be down there. Come on, give me... There we go. This is going to be hopping, man. This is going to be hopping. The Ostrich Hotel ain't got nothing on this. By the way, we still need a name for this building. I know you guys gave me some ideas for names. Nothing really caught my eye. So this building's still up for being named. Just don't put my name in it. Like, not, like, cage building or anything like that. Don't put my name in it. But just think of, like, beer... and parties and chicks and bars, and give me a name for this thing. I'm really curious to see what you guys come up with. Okay, go there. So this is gonna go right here and here. Whoops. Okay. If you guys see any mistakes I'm making up here, I will fix them off camera. I'm pretty sure I'm not making any mistakes. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to grab a screenshot. And if I did mess up, I will just, you know, fix them off camera. Let's make a few more of these. We can always burn these if we made too many, which we probably will. Okay. Come on. Come on. I can't wait for the Fun Pimps to put in simple rotation. The Fun Pimps are going to put in something called simple rotation, which, like... we'll make it so it only rotates on, like, one axis going in a circle. But if you put on advanced rotation, then it'll give you all the rotations. Because, like, a lot of these rotations we don't use a lot. So it's just kind of annoying. So I'm really happy that they're doing that. It's going to make things a lot easier. Okay. All right. Is this ceiling done? It looks... actually, I think I did it right. I'm pretty sure I did it right. I'm pretty sure I've done it right. Very good. Very good. All right, let me just go ahead and do the roof in here. And then that will be, I mean, we're pretty much done. We just have to put some lights up, get those iron bars done. The only thing I don't like about these in here is it makes it so I can't really put lights in here. I'm going to have to find a place for lights. I don't really know how I'm going to do it. At this point, I don't even know how I'm going to do it. I made these industrial lights, but... I don't know. Well, you know, probably one right here and one right there might be enough lights for the whole area. Not really sure. Okay, let's see what we got in here. All right, another 24 business glass block. Let's take it. Got some iron bars here. We got some glass blocks. Let's get up there. My idea is to finish this build up and then during the night put down the lights. You know, I like to put down the lights at night because that's where you could tell where you're going to need the lights most. So I went ahead and finished the walkway around. It looks pretty good. I like it. I like it a lot. Yep, looking nice. And yeah, like I said, we'll put the lights in at night, and then that way we can see where we're gonna need them. All right, so let's go to the iron bars. The only problem with the iron bars is, oh boy, ah, damn it, I put it in the wrong spot. The only problem with the iron bars is they take for freaking ever to craft. Man, did they take a long time. I want to put these in from the inside, by the way. Otherwise, they won't line up properly. See, now that one lines up. All right, let's put the glass in. Glass. Iron bars, take that out, more iron bars. Okay, looking good. Looking good. 2, 3, 4. Okay, what do we need? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six more iron bars. Okay, we should have that pretty soon. And then at that point, we will put up the lights. It will be nighttime. We'll turn off this, put up some lights, and we will call it a rooftop patio party. Whatever you want to call it. I don't know. But it's going to be pretty sweet. And by the way, I did go ahead and do some farming during the stream. And I'm hoping that this... I'm really praying that this chrysanthemums come in properly this time. Because last time they didn't. It was a bug. The game has no way of your crops to fail. The fact is the game was just bugged, but I'm rationalizing it in my head with the crops died because of cold weather or bugs or something like that, which is something pretty cool. They should put like bugs and cold weather and stuff in the game, something that would kill your crops. I think that would be a really nice addition. I've been asking for that for a long time, and I don't want my crops to die. You know, it's kind of annoying, but at the same time, it gives you a reason to have farms and bigger farms, you know, because otherwise you could stockpile food and food gets too easy. So I would like to see some way for the farms to be destroyed, you know, randomly because of bugs or insects. Maybe you could spray for them or something. I don't know. I know Starvation Mod has... I think Starvation Mod has just introduced that feature. Although I'm not sure. I don't know for sure, but I think they have. All right, we're going to wait for pitch dark because I do not want to bother until it's pitch dark. But this room is basically done now. Except we need to start growing some barley too because we got a lot of beer fridges in this freaking game, like in this world. As a matter of fact, I think I have another one in my room. Yep, and we got to start filling these things up with beer, man. We got the coolers, but you know, we got no beer, man. Like, it's no good. That's no good, my man. All right, so let's see what we got over here. We should get the iron bars. We don't need anymore. We'll take more just in case we ever do need them. All right, so this, we're gonna put some more. I'm going to put that in there. This thing's getting lead because you need lead for some things. And I'll just, I don't know, I'll use it for bullet cases. What we could do is turn it off, put that up there, turn it back on. Now we can make bullet casings in here if we want to, or bullet tips or whatever. So that would be pretty nice. Pretty nice. Okay, so we got a lot of gunpowder here. Let's go ahead and put the gunpowder where it belongs. You know, we got a decent amount of gunpowder there. It's not a lot of gunpowder, but it's a decent amount of gunpowder. It's something. Oh, I had some chairs too. I wanted to put some chairs up here. I don't think I'm going to have room for them at this point. I made a bunch of chairs to put up here in the patio area. Excuse me. The only thing is I found the bar stools. So I don't really have any need for the chairs anymore. It's not really that big of a deal because I can always burn the chairs. I can't even put them out here. I mean, you could probably put one here just for some looks. Yeah, a couple there. That looks nice. But other than that, I don't even see any other place for chairs. No. I mean, you could probably put a couple here facing out. Yeah, actually, that's not bad. That's not bad. And then a couple here. Yeah, just some... Yeah, why not? You know, you could... Okay, so imagine you come up here, you come into Cage's... well, I don't want to put my name in it, but... Maybe call it the something bar and grill. Okay, you come into the something bar and grill, and you grab yourself a beer. Now, I don't know where we're grilling up here, but, you know, whatever. I guess we're not. And you're just kind of sitting down. You're like, you know what? I want some more fresh air. This place is really, like, roomy, and it's got a lot of airflow through it. But I just kind of want to come out here and just, you know, let's just sit down and take in the view. Let's just take in the view. Oh, such a beautiful night. Let's do this right. There we go. F7 gets rid of the UI. Just kind of sitting down, drinking a beer, taking in the view. Maybe mountains aren't your thing. Maybe you want to come over here and take in the... Well, there's still more mountains, but maybe... Oh, you can see the prison from here. Look at that. There's the prison. I think I see Rick Grimes from here. What's up, Rick? What's up, man? Yeah, we got some... Shut up timer. We're doing role play. So, yeah. So, you know... Oh, look. The Shamway. Oh, cool. Shamway. Or maybe you want to see what's going on at the Ostrich Hotel. Hey, man. The Ostrich Hotel has some sexy parties. You know, maybe, I'll bet you right now, like, you'd just be sitting here watching National Hotel and a couple of co-eds might come out on the balcony over there, on the top balcony. And, you know, maybe if you're cute or something, they'll, like, flash you or something. You don't know. This stuff could happen. Just because it's a zombie apocalypse doesn't mean there's not, you know, flashing co-eds at the Ostrich Hotel. You never know. That's what I'm saying. You have to be here in position because they could be flashing your buddy, and your buddy comes in and says, oh, Cage, yeah, these two co-eds out there flashing, go come look, and then they're not there, and you missed your opportunity. I mean, come on, guys. You got to be ready for that. Or if you're just like me and you're married, you know, you're not into that no more. You just kind of, you just kind of chill out. Oh, there's the girls flashing. Oh, and your wife's sitting next to you. So, I got to look away, you know. Who knows? I don't know what the hell I'm talking about at this point. All right. I could almost see my old base. I'll bet you if I turned up my view distance, I could see my old base from here. And right there, you could see all my traps when I was doing the outside stuff. I really like this world. This world's come out very, very well. All right, let's bring back our UI. All right, it is sufficiently nighttime. Let's go ahead and put these lights up and call this a video. All right, how's that going to do for me? It's too high up, isn't it? Yeah, kind of. Oh, yeah, those are too high up. I mean, they're not a bad spot. Oh, boy. So, I don't know how I'm going to get some lights in here, then. Maybe is there any kind of standing lights? I mean, I don't like these mobile spotlights. The street light's too big. That's for outside. I don't know, guys. I don't know what I'm going to do for lights in here. Because it's all glass. I might just do torches up here. We'll have those lights up there for whatever. And I think we'll just do torches up here. And I normally like to use lights inside. But technically, that's not really inside. It's more of an outdoor thing. Now, I don't mind using lights outdoors. But I think torches would fit more into the feeling of an outdoor bar and grill type thing. Like, if you go to a bar, like, on the beach or something, or go to some, you know, place like that, you probably see a lot of torches, like, standing torches and stuff, like, in real life, you know? So, I think the torches kind of fits in with the feeling of the bar and grill. And it'll look okay on glass as well. Where'd I put the second one? Oh, well. Is that enough? Yes. So that looks pretty good. I kind of like that. And the torches are okay inside because of all the ventilation up here. I think that's going to work out just fine. Yeah, definitely. You know what? Torches is definitely the way to go here. It definitely has a lot more in spirit with what this is all about. Where is it? There, and there, and one right here. That should be plenty of light up here. Not really plenty of light over here. Let's put down two over here. Yeah, that's good. See, that's mood lighting, people. That's mood lighting. That's what I'm talking about. Might even be too many torches inside. Yeah, that works. Yeah. Yes, that is pretty nice. We got some emergency lights up here just in case, I don't know, a wind blows or something and all the torches go out. I don't know. I'm going to leave those lights up there because I like them. I might try and figure out a way to get electrical lights in here, but I don't know. I kind of think this is the way to go. I kind of think the torches just fit. What do you guys think? You think I should go out of my way to get electrical lights in here, or you think torches fit in with the idea of the build up here? I personally think the torches are perfect. All right, guys, we're going to call this one here. The patio is done. That makes me very happy. I'm going to wait out the night and get a great screenshot. But that is going to be it for this video, and I will see you next time. Till then, take it easy.